Hi folks, this tutorial will introduce the powerful new features in iClone 8's face puppet animation approach. Experienced iClone 7 users will already be familiar with the system, but there are some important new concepts which it will really help to become familiar with. I'm starting here with one of Reallusion's great new scan-derived demo characters, Kevin. And going to the Modify Animation panel, I open up the familiar face puppet interface with the list of available full face control sets on the left and the solo feature selection interface on the right. The avatar's facial profile is shown at the top, so the Kevin model here is currently using CC4 extended, and the profile determines which controls are available for use with the current expressions. Each control set is a folder containing individual controls to be selected below, and you can see tooltips for the controls by hovering the mouse over each thumbnail. You'll also find that selecting a full face control will display which parts of the face are active on the solo feature interface. More on that later. But first, I want to introduce the new controls which work with CC4 profiles. It's really important to test face puppet by previewing before recording. So to explain the new controls, I'll go through them step by step, previewing them each time. The first set provides different combinations of eyes, brows, and head turning controls, specifically to focus on where the character is putting their attention. You'll find these not only useful for close-up facial animation like this, but also larger scenes and in combination with techniques like the new motion director tools. The six controls in the first set provide a systematic approach to character focus, which can be used as an alternative to or combined with modified panel lookout constraints. The first two controls on the left provide eye focus with minor head rotation, with and without brow motion, whilst the middle two combine eyes with full head rotation, again with and without brows, and the final two maintain forward eye focus whilst turning the head, also with and without brows. Now, if you're finding a particular control seems too weak or too strong, you can always use the global strength slider here on the right. But as I continue to preview the controls, please note how the greater the distance between the mouse cursor and the center of the face puppet guide, the stronger the driven expression will be. This is why it's really important to preview, to test face puppet controls before recording, in order to be able to gauge the strength, as well as the speed at which you want to control the face using the mouse. So, the first control set provides different ways to focus the character's attention, whether that's on the camera, another character, or an object in the scene. And in terms of workflow, it's not a rule, but it can provide a useful starting point when blocking out animation. The next control set provides ways to quickly introduce emotional content through expressions in face puppet. And you can see immediately that more facial parts are indicated when these controls are selected. Looking at the first control, its tooltip describes four emotions closed, which means that each axis, up, down, right and left, will drive a different emotion, and that the mouth remains closed. So upwards motion is for happy, down for sad, left for fear and right for anger, along with fixed eye focus and slight head motion. This profile is ideal for rapid puppetry to block out emotional content quickly before further detailing and polishing. And with the mouth always closed, it won't interfere with lip syncing. The second control in this set provides a way to quickly animate a character agreeing or disagreeing, along with facial expressions. So, diagonal mouse motion towards upper left will cause the avatar to smile and nod, and diagonal motion towards lower right will cause frowning and head shaking. The next four controls in the second set also provide new, alternative face puppet approaches which can help with building up facial animation quickly. Each of these is a full face emotion control, including slight head motion and frontal fixed eye focus, where mouse up and left will maintain mouth closure, which can be more useful during lip sync, and mouse right will open lips, and down will open both lips and jaw. These four controls from left to right are labelled Joy Delight, Anger Rage, Contempt Disgust and Shock Horror respectively, and are best suited for shorter clips and sequence editing where stronger full face expressions are needed. Though again, remember that smaller mouse movements, as well as the strength slider, can be used for more subtle effects. Moving on to the third set of new full face controls, these combine full head turns along with frontal eye focus in the same way as some of the first set controls. The difference is, The third set combines emotional expressions with the head turns, following Reallusion's already established convention of using six primary emotions of happy, sad, angry, disgust, fear, and surprise. Head rotation being a big part of these profiles, they can be less practical than others during lip sync and may be more useful between sections of speech. Now, as you can see, combining full head turns with emotional expressions does produce quite comprehensive animation, and it might seem that controls like this are so specific that they could be difficult to use in practice, but that's not the case at all, since they can of course be edited and remixed in further animation passes. What these new controls do provide is a number of alternative ways and workflows with which to produce face puppet animation, whether that's starting with the character's attention, their eyes and head focus, or quickly blocking in more comprehensive full face expression sequences to create emotional content, or blending the two. Moving on from the new control sets, the CC4 Extended and Standard Facial Profiles are also provided with updated CC3 Plus face puppet controls, both for full face expressions and facial parts. The full face jaw closed and jaw open expressions again provide the six emotions approach, with mouth variations of closed and open lips and jaw, again for use during as well as between sequences of lip sync. You'll notice that these full face controls do not include eyes or head rotation, so that by default, these expressions are designed for blending with additional motion on these parts. And looking now at the sets of parts controls, these have also been updated from CC3 to make the most of the new CC4 expression sets. So new expressions have been combined into the controls wherever possible. Updating expressions has also included extending blink controls, where now any expression which includes eye selection can use left mouse click during face puppet as a method to activate blinks quickly. So here, going back to the first full face control, left clicking whilst using face puppet will provide blinks, and this will work for any control where eyes are visibly selected. And as well as familiar controls like blinks and squints, you'll also find variations on cross-eyed expressions, as well as iris dilation and contraction, which is specific to the new expressions in the CC4 extended profile. It's important to appreciate that part face controls are designed for blending with other animated parts, and that in isolation like this, these controls are just providing building blocks to create new, as well as to edit existing facial animations. And as you explore face puppets controls, particularly with avatars using the CC4 extended profile, it's worth considering just how comprehensive this face puppetry approach is, and how straightforward it is to use these individual controls, whether at the level of full head and face animation, or working with individual parts like this. And you'll find new controls like neck swallowing and tightening, as well as a new head translation control, and two new character-specific control sets which have been optimized to work with their custom extended facial profiles. Again, these provide variations on head turns, eye focus, as well as facial expressions, this time set up to be more individual and specific to the particular character's face. Now, full face controls are just one side of face puppet's capability. The other side is solo feature selection. So using the eraser tool to deselect currently selected parts and then selecting a feature, this provides another set of feature controls. But the big difference between full face control sets and solo feature selections is that using full face controls on their own means using them one at a time, whilst using the solo feature approach allows you to combine different controls on multiple features. So instead of being limited to using a specific control for an animation recording pass, you can mix and match various solo feature selections with various controls to produce the animation effects you want in a controllable way. And here, whilst I'm just using eye and brow selections to produce particular effects, of course you can select and combine features across the whole face if you wish, but it's important to realize that you can also use solo feature selections in combination with full face controls. So going back to one of the full face controls I demonstrated earlier, you can see that selecting the full face control shows which parts of the face are active on the solo feature selection interface. They're highlighted in a pastel green color. And if I then go to make a solo feature selection, you can see that the highlight is brighter and the solo feature controls become available below. Now, you can go back to the original complete full face control using the left-hand revert button, but by adding a solo feature selection, this will always override the current full-faced control on the selected part. And if you don't want to add a solo feature but want to mask out a part on a full-face control so that it remains inactive during an animation pass, simply click again on the selected solo feature to mask that part. So it's a single click on a highlighted part of a full face control to override it with a solo feature control, and another click to mask the part altogether. Of course, to quickly mask, just double click. And just to sum up in terms of control approaches, you can use full face controls or solo feature selections as independent methods, or you can combine them together, as well as mask out parts on full face controls. So I'm sure you'll find that there are many combinations and possibilities for facial control within iClone 8's updated face puppet approach. So far, all I've done is demonstrate the different controls using face puppet's real-time preview approach. And as I said earlier, before recording with face puppet, it's really important to test the controls so that you can gauge how you will use them when making the recording, so that you can get a feel of how things are going to work. To finish off, we'll quickly go through the basic principles of recording face puppet. And I could start from scratch, but I'll begin here with the stock animation sequence I began with earlier, and use face puppet to change what's happening in the existing sequence. I've decided I want to change the eye animation and replace it so that Kevin looks around in a different way. I could do this using solo feature, but here I'll use the full face eye look control. You can see it's now highlighted the eyes. And next, I change Face Puppet's recording mode from Blend to Replace, because I want to replace the eye animation. And as I make the recording, whilst the rest of the animation stays the same, I'm using the mouse to redirect the character's gaze, and in the process, overwriting the original eye keyframes. So, Replace mode literally replaces any existing animation on the part or part which is currently selected. It's a way of controllably editing facial parts as separate tracks on the timeline, and you can do it on any part of the character's face and head. And it doesn't matter how the current animation was created, whether it's motion capture, keyframed, or a fully face puppet created sequence, you can replace the parts. Whether it's the eyes, eyebrow, nose, cheeks, mouth, jaw, or head animation, you can replace them all, in whatever way you wish. Face Puppet's Replace mode allows you to do just that, replace animation. Whereas Blend mode allows you to add to the existing animation. It combines new expression values with the existing track, without removing anything which was already there. So here I'm adding in some jaw and mouth animation which is being combined on the existing track. If I'd used Replace mode here, then the lips would have stopped moving. But since I'm using Blend mode, nothing from the existing animation is being lost. You can see how the mouth remains just as expressive as it was before, only with the addition of naturalistic jaw opening and closing through the sequence. Face Puppet Blend and Replace modes are very powerful tools for editing existing clips, but of course you can always start a new Face Puppet animation if you wish, by changing the recording mode to new. Here, I select one of the full face profiles, and at any point on the timeline, I can simply overwrite the existing clip with the new animation. And in this case, everything from the previous clip has been overwritten in a single pass. But as you can see, there's quite a jolt between the original animation and the newly created clip. So to address this, I simply zoom into the timeline and adjust the clip transition to smooth it out. So finally, just to show how amazingly flexible the face puppet recording process can be, having created a new clip halfway through the existing clip, I'll use Replace mode to replace the eye animation through that transition period. This tutorial has covered iClone 8's updated face puppet approach, including full face and solo feature controls, and how they can be used together, as well as using them with the different recording modes. I hope it's been helpful, and thanks for watching.